His word is enough, too. You see, picking up from where we left off, this man had faith in Jesus Christ, being that he was a man of authority himself, and that he could have faith in Jesus Christ. Jesus could not believe that someone that was not of the stock of Israel could have so much faith. And he turned around and said that he had never met such faith in Israel. One of the things that make the word of God works in anybody's life is faith. You have to have faith in the word. You could believe in Jesus Christ and whatever and make heaven, but if you don't believe in his own word, it will be impossible for the word to do a lot of changes in your life. Now that the man had faith, Jesus was able to speak. And when Jesus Christ spoke, the boy whom was at home got well. The boy was a faithful servant. That was why the word works. You and I have to be faithful servants to Jesus, like that man, like the servant of the Roman officer was. Once we are faithful servants and we have faith in God, his word is all that we need, and it's enough, more than enough, to take care of whatever problems we have. I don't know what problem you have. Is it sickness? Have you been faithful to Jesus Christ? Yeah, his word is enough. If it is problems you have, financial problems you have, and you're faithful to him, his word is enough. His word is enough when you are faithful servant. His word is enough when you believe in him. His word is enough, is enough when you serve the others. His word is enough when all you got is enough for you to use it. Others, his word is enough. When you're not selfish, his word is not enough. It's enough. When you're not selfish, his word is enough. See, the Roman officer was an unselfish person. He wasn't asking for a favor for himself. So the word of God worked more often than not. The problem we've always had is because we have always been selfish in our lives. And saying selfish, it's kind of hard for God to ever help us. The reason for why we've always had problems is because most of our prayers are selfish prayers. And since they are selfish prayers, God does not hear such prayers. God prefers prayers that are selfless, that are aimed at either glorifying his name or uplifting his name or getting people to come to know him. When we pray for the progress of others, and that is also walking in the vineyard of Jesus Christ, God will, without our asking him, be walking on our vineyard. May God Almighty make us know that the word of God is enough. When God wanted to change the world, it was his word he said. That's what we need. If there has to be a revival in the land at all, we have to take it upon ourselves, become duty bound to practice in his word. Until we practice his word, we will never ever get whatever we want, however hard we try. Whatever our faith is, but we don't believe in his word, that Jesus is the authority of God, we can't get whatever we want. Everything you want can be gotten when you believe in the Son of Man. Once you believe in the Son of Man, and believing in the Son of Man is obeying his commandments, which is basically, like I've always told you, love, you get whatever you want. May God give us the love we have for God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.